Hello children, once again I welcome you on to 9th standard second language English. I am Mahesh Ropan, working as an assistant teacher at Akma Devi Girls High School, Beirut. Okay children, so in the previous video classes we have discussed so many units regarding to 9th standard second language English, and we are continuing the same video classes for the remaining units for this year. Okay, I hope all of you are ready with your pen and paper. Okay children, my question is, if you get help from anybody or from your any friends or relative or anybody, okay, and you may imagine you have got the help from anybody, what is your response? How you are going to respond? Come on. Okay. Suppose, if I get help from anybody, what I am going to do is, everybody used to say, what? Yes. Thank you. Right? It's the best way to show our gratitude. Look at this word. Gratitude. I have written already on the blackboard. Gratitude. It's our duty to show gratitude towards the people from what they have got, what we have got help. Okay. So in so many ways we can show our gratitude. Thank you. Thank you very much. I am grateful to you, right? Thankful to you. We may show our gratitude in a better way also. I thank you from the bottom of my heart. Look at this word. I thank you from the bottom of my heart. So in these ways we are expressing our gratitude in these ways to the people what we get help from them, right? Have you understood? Okay, let us move on. Gratitude here means, in Kannada we say krutagnate. Children, what do we say? Krutagnate. We should have gratitude for the help what we got from others. Right? Every day, right? Every day, our eyes, look at here. Every day, our eyes help us to see each and everything. Whatever we do or whatever happens around. What? Our eyes help us to see whatever is happening around me. Our hands, look at here, our hands help us to do, right? What? Any kind of work. Our legs help us to move wherever I need. If I want to go anyway, which organ will help me? Our legs. If I want to do some work, which organ will help? My hands. If I want to speak, now I am speaking. Which organ is? My lips are helping me to speak. If I want to get smell, my nose. If I want to hear, yes. In these ways, our eyes, nose, lips, ears, hands, legs. What are these, my dear children? Yes, angangalu, Kannadadalli, right? Organs. What do we say? Organs of our body. Organs of our body. So in LKG, UKG, in the preliminary stage, we have learned all these things. Parts of the bodies. Right? So, some of our important organs which we are using daily, right? Suppose eyes to see, ear to hear, nose to smell, hands to do some work, legs to move wherever I need. So have you thanked your hands? Look at this question. Have you thanked your hands? Any day? Have you thanked your legs? Have you thanked your lips? Have you thanked your heart? No. We are using these organs dying. Right? Throughout our life, we are using these organs. Even though we are not showing gratitude towards these organs. Have you thanked your heart? Or have you thanked your ears? No. So, these organs are blessed by whom? Yes. These organs are blessed by God. Right? These organs are blessed by God. Yes, obviously, God is the creator. Creator means, bakla? Creator. Yes. Creator. In Kannada, we say, Srushtikartha. Yes. He samasta jagatina srushti. Karta, God. God is the creator of this entire world. So, he has also a power to destroy. So we can also call him as a destroyer. If you wish, he can destroy. Right? So this should not be happening as we wish. So he was a creator. He is also having a power to destroy. You keep this thing in your mind. Don't forget it. Right? We should be grateful, right, to our organs. So these organs are the gift of God, who is the creator of this entire world. And God has blessed us with all these organs correctly. My hands are working properly, my legs, my nose, my eyes, right? Suppose, just imagine, my dear children, will you feel comfortable without your eyes? You just imagine, for a moment, you have no eyes. Can you imagine a moment without eyes? No, it's highly impossible, right? Can you imagine a moment without your hands for a day? No, it's really impossible. So, that we should be thankful, or we should be grateful to the God. Our God means here the organs, what he has given us. These organs are the gift of the God. So we should be grateful to these organs. On the other hand, if we are grateful to these organs, we are grateful to God. Look at this. We never thought in this way to thank our organs. ಈ ತರಹ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಂಗಾಂಗಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಕೃತಜ್ಞತೆ ಸಲ್ಲಿಸಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಕನಸು ಮನಸ್ಸಿನಲ್ಲೂ ಎಣಿಸಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ. ಹೀರ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಗಿಫ್ಟ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಟು ದ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಗಾಡ್. ಸೋ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದ ಗಾಡ್ ಆರ್ ಟು ದ ಗಾಡ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದ ಗಾಡ್ ಆರ್ ಟು ದ ಗಾಡ್ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ಫುಲ್. ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ದ ಗಾಡ್. ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಸೋ? So, in the same way, my dear children, what is happening here? In your textbook, there is a second poem. It's called Gratefulness. What is the name? Gratefulness. Through this poem, the poet is going to tell us about poet's gratitude. Look at the word gratitude. What do we say in Kannada? Krutagnate. Gratitude towards the God. Do you know what is the name of the poem? Gratefulness. Gratefulness. Right? Let us enjoy the poem today. So, who is the poet? Let's now have a look about the poet. The name of the poet is Joseph T. Rinaldi. Joseph T. Rinaldi. I hope all of you have textbook. A photo was given in your textbook. You please watch it, right? So know about the poet.
This is the poem about expression of gratitude. This is the theme of the poem is expression of gratitude. Expression of gratitude. This is the theme, main theme. Expression of gratitude towards the benefit of what we get. Right. Joseph D. Rinaldi has spent 40 years in the field of education. Look at this. This poet has spent 40 years. It's a huge period. 40 years, long period. 40 years in the field of education. Man, it's a great field. It's a very important field because in the development of a nation, education plays a very important role. So this person, Joseph T. Rinaldi, has spent his 40 years of lifespan in the field of education. Got it? Since his retirement, he spent much of his time in the visual arts, especially writing. So what he has done in his 40 years of education field? Writing, painting, drawing, woodcraft. Look at this, multitasker. Yes, he has capability to do multitasks. What a talent he is. That is creative person. Says we may say him as creative person, the person who is having a creativeness. Vasa vasa dana srushtisuvantadu enu iruttala makkala antaru navu creative srujanaatmaka vyaktigalu antu karitaru. So he has many skills, painting skill, writing skill, drawing skill, wood crafting skill also he has. So his popular poems are mainly A Binding Relationship, A Birthday Greeting, A Bountiful Harvest. Right? These are his main poems. And his poem, Graduation Day. What was the name of the poem? His Graduation Day is the most read of all the poems he has written. ಅವರು ಬರೆದಿರುವಂಥವರಲ್ಲಿ ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಪ್ರಶಂಸೆಗೆ ಪಾತ್ರವಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಜುಯೇಷನ್ ಡೇ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ರೀಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಪೋಯಮ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ರಿಟನ್. ಓಕೆ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಟೆಲ್ ಯು, ಹಿಯರ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ವರ್ಡ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೋ ಗ್ರೇಟ್, ಅನದರ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇ, ರೈಟ್? So while writing great, we are using this word. What a great man Gandhiji is. What a great man. What a great personality. So while writing that sentence, we are using G-R-E-A-T. Right? So here, when we come to the expression, right? While expressing gratefulness, gratitude, we are using great. Great, great, G-R-A-T-E. Pronunciation is looks like little bit same, but spellings are different, meanings are different. This kind of words are also called as homophones. What do we call these kind of words? Homophones. Shall I give another example? C, C. Right? See. I want to see the cinema. I saw the sea. Right? We visited him. We visit Murdeshwara. There we saw the sea. Right? Next. What do we say? Meet. Meet. Yesterday I met my friend. Past tense. I meet my friend. I meet my friend. Suppose if I want to write it in a past tense, I met my friend yesterday. Right. Meet baby. Meat. The dog eats a piece of meat. Right. Here, mom's is a thud. Okay. Meet mom's. Right. So in this way, this kind of words are called homophones. Why I
given these examples, while using these words, we should be aware of the meaning of the words. At the time of writing also, don't mistake great, right? Little bit confusing. While we use great, usually this word we are very familiar with this one, great. This is while showing expression towards gratitude, right? Don't be confused. Don't make a mistake while writing this word, great. Don't write this one while writing this. Okay, let us get into the poem. So before going to start the poem, here we have a small passages, activity is given. What activity is given? Before you read is given. So I will read the passage, it's a small passage. You observe the things, observe the pronunciation of the words and voice variation, right? Then you practice at home. Then after my completion of reading, you have to go through the questions given below and answer to me. Right? Are you ready, guys? Okay. Sunita was badly injured in an accident. Sunita was badly injured in an accident. Her leg was fractured. She was operated upon and the broken bone was joined using a steel rod. Her leg was joined with a steel rod. She was advised to rest for a month. She could not move. She was angry that God had been very unfair to her. Her friend Anjali comforted her, saying that she should look at those who were physically challenged since birth and be grateful to the Creator. Be grateful to the Creator. What do we say? Creator. I have already told you, Srishtikarta, right? Creator. So now discuss in groups and find answers from the following. I hope, my dear children, you are going to find the answers. Okay, I will give you 2 or 3 minutes time. Go through these questions. I will read the questions once or twice. Within that one, we have to be get ready, right? Let's see the first question. Was Smita right in being angry with the God? Was Smita right in being angry with the God? Angry means sick. When Smita was injured, she became very angry towards the God. Is it right, my dear children? Yes. No. Right? Correct? What is your answer? No. It's the right answer. No. Smita was not right. Why? Suppose if you get any trouble, or if you are in a difficult situation, as human beings, we do what we are going to do? Shapastivi Devarane. It's all my fate. Right? Devarane Shapastivi now. Kelavane. So don't do like that. In the same way, Smita also angry with the God. It's not right. Okay, second question. How did Anjali comfort Sunita? Look at the passage. Answer is itself in the passage. Find the sentences, find the lines. How did Anjali comfort Sunita? Did is used in the sentence. What kind of sentence it is? Yes, do, does, present tense, did, past tense. Right? The question is in past tense. We have to answer in the same tense, past tense. So, there is another word, comfort. Comfort is in present tense. Did is in past tense. But the main verb is in present tense. Why? Did past tense. Again, in the same sentence, the word comfort is used in the present form. In your sentence, both the tense forms are there. Yes, it is a rule in English. If the first verb is in past, right? If you use a helping verb in past form, no chance to use the principal verb, main verb in past tense. We have to keep it in the present form. While answering, our answer should be in the same tense. So that is why we have to change this comfort into comforted. Right? What will come? Comfort, comforted. Look at that. In the below the from below the third line, Anjali comforted her. Her here refers to Smita, Sunita, right? Sunita comforted her, saying that she should look at those. She should look those who were physically challenged. Okay, physically challenged. It's a very beautiful word. So in the olden days, we are using handicaps, right? Whose organs are not in proper way. Somebody having no eyes, we may call him blind. Somebody has no chance to speak, dumb, right? So in this way, now his hand were not working properly. He can't able to walk. He can't able to do his work. So in this way, they are called handicaps. But it is, the term was changed. Now we are using a new word because they are not useless people. They are very challenging people than us. Namagintalu hechu samarthya ullavaru avaralli nodi. We have two hands, we can't write, we are lazy, right? The person who is having no hand, he has a capacity, he has shown, I can write with the help of legs, right? What a challenging person they are, persons they are. And they are called as they are doing such a things which the people, what the organs we have in the right condition, we can't do. ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಂಗಾಂಗಗಳು ಸರಿ ಇರುವ ನಾವು ಮಾಡಲಾಗದ ಕೆಲಸಗಳನ್ನು ಅವರು ಮಾಡಬಲ್ಲರು. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಒಲಿಂಪಿಕ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲಿ ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್ ಒನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮೆಡಲ್ ಇನ್ ಹೈಜಿನ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಟ್ರೂತ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೈ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಚಾಲೆಂಜಿಂಗ್ ಪೀಪಲ್. ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್, ಫಿಸಿಕಲಿ ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್. So Anjali is comforting Sunita by saying that look at those physically challenged since they have birth. Since birth. ಹುಟ್ಟಿನಿಂದಲೂ ಅವರು ಅಂಗವೈಕಲ್ಯವನ್ನಿದ್ದಾರಲ್ಲ ಅವರನ್ನು ನೋಡೋದು ಈಗ ಆಗಿರೋದು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ವೇ ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ಕಂಫರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಜಲಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕಂಫರ್ಟ್ ದೆಮ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ಫುಲ್ ಟು ದ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟರ್. Who should be grateful to? Who should be grateful to? Now, yariga kritagnara agirbeku? That is the creator. Who is the creator? God. We should be grateful to God. And why? Because he has given us all the organs. He has given us all the organs which we can live happily. Only with the help of these organs, we are living happily. We are feeling, we are living a comfortable life. We are feeling happy. Without these organs, we can't feel. Suppose, imagine, for a moment we have no eyes. We can't. Right? So that is why we should be grateful to God. That is expression of gratitude towards the God, creator. Okay, that's take an introduction about the poem. Every human being is blessed with such organs as eyes, ears, lips and hands. Every human being. Human beings have also a heart. Yes. Heart to love. Why we have heart? We have a heart to love. And a mind that gives them the ability to help others. Right? Heart is to love. Mind is to, for what? To help. Have the ability to help others. Okay.
The poet says that one has to be grateful to the Creator for granting all such possessions. Possessions means here, and we can say facilities. What facilities the God has provided us? He suggests that a good and positive use of the organs and the grace of the Creator be made. What is the wish of the God? What is the wish of the poet? What is the wish of the poet? Joseph T. Rinaldi is saying that the God has given all these organs a good use. Look at this. With the hand, I may write the poem. Right? With these hands, I can also make a model. What the poet is telling, a good, we have lips. I can talk beautiful words. I can say the words to you to comfort somebody, to help somebody, to comfort. Sometimes I can talk to you. Otherwise, I can abuse. Why go to kill? So, a good use of the organs be made. What is the wish of the poet is, a good use of the organs be made. So, with this concern, the poet has written a beautiful poem, Gratefulness. We never imagined to show a gratitude towards our organs. For somebody, we can say, we show our gratitude. Thank you, man. Thank you very much. I will be very grateful to you. I thank you from the bottom of my heart. So, we are showing. But every day we are using these organs, we are never taught, we never came across to thank these organs. The poet is doing this thing through the poem. Okay, let us start the poem. A very beautiful poem, and it is very simple poem. The language which used in the poem is very simple. Okay. First stanza. I am grateful for the eyes that I can see, the activities that can be done by me. I am grateful for the ears. I may hear the sobbing of those who need me near. Look at this. In the first stanza, the poet is showing gratitude towards eyes and what? Ears. Okay. The poet is showing gratitude towards eyes and ears. Eyes. We may consider eyes as the light of life. Yes? What do we consider? Light. Light of life. Jeevanada bilaku. Yadu? Kannu. Right? Light of life. The poet says that he is grateful for the eyes and ears. Eyes. Look at here. I am grateful for the eyes. Why the poet is grateful for the eyes? He can see the activities done by me. Me means ears, him. The activities, what I am going to do. Right? What are the work or activities I am going to do? I can see. Which organ is going to help to see the activities? What I have done by me? My eyes. Yes? ನಾನು ಮಾಡಿದ ಕೆಲಸಗಳನ್ನು ನೋಡಲು ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡುವ ನನ್ನ ಕಣ್ಣುಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಕೃತಜ್ಞ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ವಂಡರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ಸನ್ರೈಸ್, ಸನ್ಸೆಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ಅ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ನೇಚರ್. ಎಸ್, ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ಮೈ ಪ್ಯಾರೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಬಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೇ ಈ ವಾಸ್ ಶೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಟಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್ ಟು ಹೈಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಈ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ದ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಡನ್ ಬೈ ಹಿಮ್. And secondly, ears. Ears. How the ears help us? To hear somebody's words. Ears helping the sobbing of the needy. Somebody is sobbing. Sobbing here refers to me crying. I was in a sorrow position. Right? I was unhappy. He need the help. Suppose, what he is saying, I am grateful for the ears that I may hear the sobbing of those who need me near, who is crying, who is in need of help from me. Yarigo nanna sahaya beku,
ಅದನ್ನು ಕೇಳಲು ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡುವ ನನ್ನ ಕಿವಿಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಕೃತಜ್ಞ. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ಫುಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಮೀ ಟು ಲಿಸನ್ ಆರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಸಾಬಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ನೀಡಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ನೀಡೆಡ್ ಮೈ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪೋಯಮ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟಾನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಾರಿ I am grateful for the lips that might speak words of comfort and peace to all who seek. I am grateful for a mind that I might know how to aid those who need me so. Look at here, we are grateful for lips and mind here. Lips and mind. Is showing gratitude for lips and mind. So lips help you to speak words comfortably and peaceful to all. So while we are comforting somebody, we have to use good words, comfortful words, which may give them comfortness, right? So what helps us at the time while comforting somebody? What helps us? Our lips helps to speak comfortable words to comfort them. He can speak kind and good words which comforts and can make peace to all who speak. ಬಯಸಿದವರಿಗೆ ಸಮಾಧಾನ ನೆಮ್ಮದಿ ಕೊಡುವ ಮಾತುಗಳನ್ನು ಆಡುವ ತುಟಿಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಕೃತಜ್ಞ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಕವಿ. And this the next one, mind that giving the ability. Look at this word. The mind that gave him the ability to help others. ಬೇರೆಯವರಿಗೆ ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಕೊಡೋದು ಯಾವುದು? ನಮ್ಮ ಮನಸ್ಸು, ರೈಟ್? ಮನಸ್ಸು ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಲ್ಲೇ ಅಂತ ನೋಡಿದ್ರ ಮನ್ಸು ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಮನ್ಸು ಮಾಡು ಅಂತಾರೆ. ಮೈಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಗೇವ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಟು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್. ಈ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಎ ಮೈಂಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ದೋಸ್ ಹೂ ನೀಡ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಮೇ ನಿಯರ್ ಹಿಮ್. Mind is the leader. We can say, what we can say? For all the organs, for the whole body, human body, mind is the leader. We can say, mind is the leader. It helps us to access to do each and every work. Right? Assess. So, access and assess. To assess, helps us to assess. To do each and every work, prati kelsa idu maadu idu beda heltakkanthade adu our mind. It helps to do each and every work. It helps us how we have to do, what we have to do, in what way we have to do, what to do, how to do, in what way we have to do. All these will be done by our mind. Bayasidavarige sahaya maaduva shakti koduttalla manasu, adakke nanu ಕೃತಜ್ಞ ಅಂತಾರೆ. ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಸೀ ದ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್. ಇಯರ್ ಏಡ್ ಇಯರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಏಡ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್. ಏಡ್ ಇಯರ್ ರೆಫರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್. ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ದೋಸ್ ಹೂ ನೀಡ್ ಮೀ ಸೋ. ದ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ಫುಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಮೈಟ್ ಡೂ ಸಮ್ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಟಾಸ್ಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯೂ. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ಫುಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ನನ್ನ ಕೈಗಳಿಗೆ ಕೃತಜ್ಞ. ಸಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ರೈಟ್, right? I am very grateful to my hands which helps me to write. I am grateful for my lips which helping me to speak and taught you, right? This is, I am grateful for the hands that I might do some hardest or simple tasks. Kastavada to solvada kelsa. Hardest means here difficult. Hardest we can say involving a lot of effort or energy. Simply we can say difficult or simple task for you. ಇತರರಿಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ದೇವರಿಗೆ ಸುಲಭದಾಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಕಷ್ಟದ್ದಾಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತ ಕೆಲಸಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡುವ ಕೈಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಕೃತಜ್ಞ ಅಂತಿದ್ದೆ. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಈಚ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಐದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ಫುಲ್. ಈ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ಫುಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ. ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಈ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ಫುಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ to pray to give him the strength and guidance every day. I am grateful for the ability. Samarthya, kya samarthya? Ability
what ability is referring here? To pray, always pray, to give me the strength and guidance every day. Pray, practice. So early morning, after when we woke up, after bath, what we are going to do? We are entering to puja room and we are making a prayer, right? Oh God, help me today, right? Like this. So this ability he has given. ಇದನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಏನನ್ನ ಕೊಡೋದು ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಕೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳ. ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರೆಫರಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗೈಡೆನ್ಸ್. ನನಗೆ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಕೊಡು, ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶನ ಕೊಡು. ಈಸ್ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಗೈಡರ್. ಗಾಡ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಗೈಡರ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ವಿ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಡೈಲಿ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ಮಿ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗೈಡೆನ್ಸ್. ಇದು ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನನ್ನ ಕೃತಜ್ಞ. ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಟು ಪ್ರೇ, ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಟು ಪ್ರೇ. ತನಗೆ ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶನ ನೀಡು, ಶಕ್ತಿ ನೀಡು ಎಂದು ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥಿಸಲು ಸಾಧ್ಯವಾಗಿರುವುದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಕೃತಜ್ಞ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವೇ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ದ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಟಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ಫುಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಐಸ್, ಇಯರ್ಸ್, ಲಿಪ್ಸ್, ಮೈಂಡ್, ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್, ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ. ಐಸ್ help us to see the activities done by me. Ears helps to hear the sobbing of the needy people. Lips help us to speak comfortable words which may comfort others. Mind is the leader which gives ability to help others. Hands to do simple or difficult tasks. Task here refers to work. Ability to pray the God give me the strength and guidance. So after all these things, the poet says there is one thing all else above, ellakkinta migilagi, that I was given a heart. Ellakkinta migilagi namage hrudayavanna kottiddanalla devaru, right? Enanna kottiddane hrudayavanna. He has given a heart to love all. Why the God has given us heart? To love. Look at this word, love. ಪ್ರೀತಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಹೃದಯವನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟರು, ದ್ವೇಷಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಅಲ್ಲ. ರೈಟ್? ವಿ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಟು ಲವ್. ಎಲ್ಲಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮಿಗಿಲಾಗಿ ಪ್ರೀತಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ, ಇತರನ್ನ ಗೌರವಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೃದಯವನ್ನು ದಯಪಾಲಿಸಿದ್ದಾನಲ್ಲ, ನಾನು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಕೃತಜ್ಞ. ಕಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದ ಮೈನ್ ಥೀಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೋಯಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ body. Now we came to know why we should be thankful, why we show gratitude towards our organs, right? Until our death we are using our organs. How we should be grateful. He is a great person who has having a thought to show gratitude towards God, right? According to the poet, we are blessed by our God. What we have is His gift. What we have is the gift of God. We should use them. Then here refers to, we should use these organs in a best way. That means in a better way. Make use of the organs made. That is the wish of the poet. We should use them in a positive way and help those who are in need. God has sent us to this world to do this work. ಇದೆ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಮಗೆ ಭಗವಂತ ಜನ್ಮವನ್ನು ನೀಡಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು. ರೈಟ್? ಗಾಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸೆಂಡ್ ಹರ್ಸ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಟು ಲವ್ ಆಲ್, ಟು ಡೂ ಸಮ್ ಯೂಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ಟು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಪೋಯಮ್. ರೈಟ್? ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದ ಪೋಯಮ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆಲ್. Go and memorize the entire poem, right? In the next class I'm going to ask for memorization. So go and memorize the entire poem. It's very simple. I hope you will do it, and I also hope you won't disappoint me in the next class. Okay, take care of yourself, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.